This video will explain how to interpret and analyze results from a standard compaction test. There are five different test results that are shown here. We have data from the mass of compacted soil, and for each test we also obtain water content. And we know that the volume of the mold was this much, 0.001 cubic meters. And the specific gravity of this soil is 2.67. If you still don't know what this test is about, please watch this video. It provides some theory about standard compaction tests. And if you would like to learn more about the procedure, please watch this YouTube video that explains step by step how this test is performed. So what we're going to do in this video, we're going to analyze the results and we're going to find the optimum water content, and also we're going to find the maximum dry density for this soil. Then we're going to plot the results, and we also will plot the results when we have 0% of A curve, this theoretical curve. And then we can determine the value of the A content at the maximum dry density. Now let's look at the solutions of this problem. In the end, we would like to get dry density, and it's already given in this column. Let's see how we get the dry density. So the first step, we need to get density, or what we call bulk density, which is mass of compacted soil divided by the volume of the compacted soil. And now let's look at the first row when we have data from the first test. You will see that the mass was 2.01 times 10 in the power of negative 3. And the volume of the mold was the same. It's given, so it's 1 times 10 in the power of negative 3. I changed it to cubic meters. And that will give us 2.01. And the units will be megagrams per cubic meters. So that's the first step. The second step is we need to get the dry density. Dry density, it's bulk density divided by 1 plus water content. Again, for the first test, we'll have that the density is 2.01 divided by 1 plus water content. In this case, we use the ratio for the water content. It's going to be 0.128, and then will give us approximately 1.782 megagrams per cubic meters. So that's what we have here in the first row. We repeat the procedure and we get dry density for each of the tests. Next point is let's see what is going to be the dry density if we assume that the air content is zero. And then we can do the same thing, for example, if we assume that air content is 10%, we can calculate the density for each of the water content that is given here in this table. So to do that, we will use the formula which is given here. And for example, if we're thinking about water content and air content, and the air content is zero. So in this case, we're going to replace this parameter A V with zero. And then I will calculate the dry density for this particular water content. So let's do it together. So dry density will be specific gravity was given to us, 2.67. times 1 minus. So for the first, for this row, when we have 0 air content, we assume it's 0, then it's going to be 1 plus water contents, it will be this one. So we're going to write 0.128 times specific gravity, 2.67, and then multiply by the density of water, which is 1 megagrams per cubic meters, and that should give us about 1.99 megagrams per cubic meters. So this is the value that we have here in the first row. So we can keep doing this. We use the same procedure. The only thing that we change for this column is the water content. So we change water content this way now. For example, if we would like to draw a line where we know that A content is 10%, so in this case, we're going to do the same thing, with the exception that here, where we have AV, we're going to write 0.1. Remember to use the ratio, not the percentage. So this is the obtained results that we draw as water content versus dry density. You can do it by hand, or if you would like, you can actually draw it using Excel. It is up to you. So what we need to do is we need to get the peak, and the peak will be somewhere here. That's the point. So this will give us maximum dry density, which is about 1.83 megagrams per cubic meters. So I'm talking about this point. And it also gives us some what we call optimum water content, about 15.2%. So these are two major parameters that we get from this test. It's the maximum dry density, and I'm going to write it here, max. And this is optimum water content. So these are two curves where we have air content 10%. So this curve will cross our experimental curve. And we have for this line where we assume that there is no air in the soil. It's not possible to achieve in nature, in real life. So this is a theoretical curve. And this curve will never cross the experimental curve, this one. You see how in this case they never touch each other. Another thing that you need to remember that in real life, in the field, it's very difficult to obtain this maximum dry density when we compact soil. That's why we would go for about 95%, which is acceptable. So in this case, we would calculate 95% of the acceptable maximum dry density. It will be maximum dry density 1.83. And 95%, we just multiply by 0.95. It will give us approximately 1.74 megagrams per cubic meters. So 1.74, I think it should be somewhere here. So this range of maximum dry density will be acceptable in the field. If you do a test in the field, and if you notice that the maximum dry density of that compacted soil is out of this range, so it's below then the maximum dry density multiplied by 0.95. In this case, the compaction process needs to be redone. With the water content, the assumption is that the water content in the field should be close to its optimum water content plus minus 1.5%. And the final point of this exercise, let's find the air content in the soil with the maximum dry density. So in this case, we're going to use the same formula as in the previous slide, which is, I'm going to write it here, this is dry density specific gravity times 1 minus air content divided by 1 plus water content times specific gravity and times density of water. So if we would like to find this value when we have maximum dry density, in this case what we need to do is we need to get the values from the graph and just find the amount of air. So it will be, I will know that maximum dry density is 1.83. and then a specific gravity is 2.67. 1 minus a content that we're going to find, divided by 1 plus. And for water content, we're going to use the optimum water content value, which is 15.2%. We change to the ratio 0.152 and times specific gravity 2.67, and also times the unit density of water, which is 1. So when we do the calculation, we'll get that EV it's approximately 0.036. So if we change it to percentage, it will be about 3.6%. So for this soil that is compacted to its maximum dry density, there will be still some air, and it will be about 3.6% out of the total volume.